So good evening, everybody. Welcome to our wellness final webinar, step three about the wellness club. So I hope you're all happy to be giving up your rainy, windy, cold Valentine's Day Friday evening to join us here. And we will try and make this as much fun as possible for you this evening. The runtime will be probably 40, 45 minutes. We have a couple of special guests who will be joining us, but I can't tell you who they are just yet. But we have people joining us from Estonia and also from Sweden. So, and we will introduce our two guests in the coming slides. So happy Valentine's Day, everybody. And I hope the weather where you are is a little better than where I am, because the trees have been blown over, it's raining cats and dogs, and it's horrible. So enough of the negative stuff. And before we talk anything more about wellness, I'm sure you would all like to hear news, whoops, if my computer would work, about our friends in Ireland, Intrum Justitia. So this is one slide, it's 100 miles an hour. As of Monday, you will find the pay button is back on our website. When you visit your page, go to the payment option, and sure enough, the pay button has returned. You click the pay button, and you can make your payment directly online via Worldpay, and your account will be updated within 30 minutes. As of Tuesday, the pay button will be available to the guys in GSO and in customer care and on Orderline. So if you are unable to do this yourself directly on the website, give customer care a call on Tuesday, and payments go through via Worldpay with immediate effect Monday and over the telephone on Tuesday. There are more options coming, and there's a PayPal coming later as well. The paperwork and some of the links will still say Intrum Justitia. Ignore it. Everything is going to Worldpay via the pay button. So that's a fantastic, for me, it's a fantastic start to a Friday evening. I don't want to talk any more about that, because this is a wellness webinar, and I will now hand you on to our first special guest, all the way from sunny, snowy Stockholm, Miss Wellness, Sofia Radomska. So welcome, Sofia.
Thank you, Eric. Thank you, and hello, everyone, and happy Valentine's Day to you all. Today, we're going to tell you how to take all which you have learned with us during the previous webinars and how you can spread the Feel Great movement through the wellness clubs. Wellness clubs will help you to attract new customers and will also help to sell more products. So what is Wellness Club about? First of all, it's about the healthy lifestyle. It will bring you health benefits. It's about the well-being. It will help you to improve the weight loss and the health results for yourself, your family, your friends, and your community. Wellness Club is also about the loyalty, because you will get the gratitude from the successful participants whose lives you have helped to change. It's about the positive word of mouth and about the new customers, of course. And it's about the Feel Great movement. So spread the movement and motivate, inspire, and change people's life. We all are social beings, and what we do, we mimic the habits and the behaviors of people around us. And it is so much more fun working together to reach the weight loss and the lifestyle goals. So friends around you will help and encourage you to reach your goals and provide the hands-on tips for strong progress. The wellness clubs, they also have the benefits to growing your business. And first of all, it's about the selling more. It's an ongoing business structure. It will help you to sell and to recruit. It's an entertaining selling, because it's much more appealing for the customers to attend such way of meetings. And it's a huge potential to increase your sales and recruits, and of course, a fast track to success. The product, selling the products and making the clubs will help you to reach new titles much faster. So how you can start the best club in town? The number one would be to make a list of whom you can invite. So examples of whom you can invite: everyone whom you have as the current wellness subscribers. Go through the list of your family and your friends. Your friends and the family and the current and former work colleagues. Anyone you know who is unhappy with their income. anyone you know who is unhappy with their health or weight, anyone you know who is looking for a new job, friends from the church, person who does your hair, nails, gardening, house cleaning, dry cleaning, delivers your pizza or delivers your paper, any friends of the friends you have recently met, who exercise regularly, it can be anyone. After you have made the list whom you would like to invite to your wellness club, the number two would be to schedule your wellness club. So pick up a date. It should be 1 or 2 weeks from today. So schedule your second one as well, and your third and your fourth. These dates are now your priority. You will now have people committed, so you will be counting, they will be counting on you. Always stick to the booked dates, and you know, have fun. The third step would be to invite people, and you can do it in different ways. You can either send the personal invitation to the people through the email, or you can post it on the social media. You can send a text through on the phone, or maybe you would prefer, some people would prefer to receive a handwritten invitation. Invite them in all possible ways. The fourth would be to promote your wellness club. So put up at your local gyms, at your local cafes, at your community centers, put up the prospecting cards. Attach the invitation to your cosmetic catalogs. When you give out the catalogs, put in the wellness catalog or put in the invitation card and inform people to whom you show the catalogs. Keep the flyers and invitation in your bag all the time. You never know if you will meet someone who is interested to attend your wellness club. Promote through the Facebook and through the social media. And I hope that you all know where you can buy our promo material. For example, such promoting invitation cards plus others, like for example, posters, banners, they can be both generic or they can be already personalized. And you can buy them through our external supplier called Printwell. You can either go on the website which you see on the screen now, or you can go into our website. After the login, you go under the sales support and advertising material, and you can place the order directly there. To help you to promote the wellness club, you can create your own attendance card, which will help you to invite new participants, but it also will help you to keep current participants active. Use this form to track the attendance of your club members and reward them at the end. Some of you have met Kieran. Kieran works in our sales support department. So today he actually has created this fantastic card for you, and it's called Wellness Club Card. You already today, it's available for you to download under in our website under the Oriflame Academy section, where you will find the slides for the Wellness Academy. So go under the Oriflame Academy section and look for the Wellness Club card. You will find the PDF file, which you can open and you can pre-fill, as you can see now on the screen, where I pre-filled with the name of the participant, Eric McLennigan, and the name of the Wellness Club owner, Sofia Radomska. I have also pre-filled the gift, which he can get if he attends 12 meetings of my Wellness Club. He can get the Wellness Hamper worth £100. So go and get these cards for you and print them and pre-fill them in advance, and you can always carry those with you and give out to people where you can, they can themselves put in their names. We will also help you to promote wellness clubs. During Catalog 4, we will open UK and ROI Wellness Facebook page. It's going to be official page where we all want to, where we want you all be there. So spread the word and share the links and let everyone be part of our fantastic UK and ROI Wellness Facebook page, which will be live in Catalog 4. There will also be some corporate support provided from the company to help you to run the wellness clubs. But details about that will be announced a little bit later. Now, let's see how the wellness club day can look like at least in theory. And to help us to tell this, we have invited back our 50-stone man, which you can see now on this picture, he has reduced some size since the start. So 50-stone man, if we can have you back, please.
Thank you for that very kind introduction. You can also see, not only have I lost weight, I've also changed sex. And I think I look far better on the right-hand side than I do on the left. But I think my voice wouldn't really match the body that you're looking at on the right-hand side of the slide there. So how do we run a wellness club? What Sophia and I will cover in the first part of this webinar is the theory. This is the generic way to run a club. And you will hear a little later on the webinar somebody who does this for real and who has achieved great success running wellness clubs. So here's a typical agenda. You must always have testimonials and you must always have somebody or some people to recognize for their great results. You need to have a checklist, you need to have today's topic, you need to have an exercise planned, you should plan a wellness product break, you should plan the weigh-in and waist measurements, and obviously therefore check on everybody's progress towards their goals. But also recall that everybody may be comfortable doing this in public. So dib, dib, dib for all of those ex-Boy Scouts, be prepared. And I'm sorry for those of you that don't know what Boy Scouts and dib, dib, dib mean. It's nothing inappropriate, but it's the motto of the Scouts. You should always be prepared. So make sure, not 5 minutes before the meeting is prepared, make sure you have everything ready to go. So scales, a measuring tape and a camera, a record like a logbook of who's attended, and also make sure that you have their contact details, just in case people change mobile phones and emails. Make sure you have a projector ready for using your PowerPoint slides for things like the roadmap, products available if people want to buy things there and then on the day, product guides, 12-week challenges, wellness catalogs, handouts, and of course some music. And I think Ghostbusters is a very good one, and also James Brown, I Feel Good. But clearly you also need to have product samples there and available. So, products and testimonials, highlights during the course of the meeting. So here are a few ideas. Natural balance shakes, you can go through the checklist with those. A testimonial, have somebody talk about satiety, about feeling full and how to use natural balance shakes or soups to crave off hunger feelings. Have somebody there talking about the men's or the ladies' wellness pack, which brings more energy or helps them sleep. Have a testimonial. I'm not sure I'd be the best example of this, but somebody who has been able to manage their stress and their emotional attachment to eating. Talk about natural balance shakes and wellness packs. Talk about optimal fat burning. I'll give you an idea on that in a couple of slides' time. Have a testimonial where somebody has got their partner or their friend to help them on their way and support their endeavors. Have somebody talk about wellness kids. I mean, this is not just about taking the vitamin supplement. It's also about getting our kids up off the sofa and out doing something healthy in the fresh air. And then also have a testimonial where somebody can talk about food and its calorific value and how to burn calories. And we're going to run through some of these really at 100 miles an hour in the next 5 minutes. You should always have a wellness product break. So here we have the most popular one, which is a natural balance shake, usually chocolate flavor. But I don't think you should restrict it just to that. So partway through the wellness club meeting, give people a chance to sample the product with a wellness break. So, and we would teach them and show them how to make the perfect shake. And I do think it's worth spending a little time preparing for this. And for those people who attended the conferences, you'll remember that we also had some fresh fruit there, some strawberries, and we presented these in a beautiful way. So make sure if you're demonstrating how to make a shake, it's not just a few shakers and scoops and some bottles of water. Make it look special. You can only sell things when people feel good about it. We also have, in Catalogue 5, a lot of new products coming, and these also can be used during the wellness break. We have two infusions here, so again, rather than maybe having a natural balance shake at one of your meetings, why not try each of the two infusions? Also, we now have the two wellness soups, and they take only a minute. Unlike the soup that Peter and I made on stage as the Swedish chefs, these are really, really great. And as I say, 1 minute and off you go. And I think the one that most people have been waiting for, and an item that we encourage people to carry around in their handbags or in their briefcases, are the new Natural Balance bars. I don't propose or don't suggest that you leave whole bars out because it becomes very expensive. Just cut them up with a knife into 4 or 5 pieces so people can sample those on the day as well. So there are a few ideas of things that you can do during the wellness break. We also need to get people involved in doing some exercise, and I don't think it is always you as the organiser that needs to decide what that exercise should be. Wellness groups work by people participating. So come up with some ideas and allow the team to decide what next week's exercise will be. So here are a few guidelines. Pick an exercise that takes a minimum of 20 minutes. We don't want people just to come and sit in a room and spend 2 hours together without doing any exercise. So make sure it's at least 20 minutes, up to 90 minutes. And there's a few ideas here. And again, when you hear from our guest speaker later, she will tell you firsthand some of the exercises that she has used to great, great success. Invite people in your club to come up with what would they like to do next time, and also allow other people to lead this. Just because you are in charge of the wellness club doesn't mean you have to be at the front and you have to manage every program. So you can empower somebody in your team to lead next week's exercise. And this also brings a bit of fun. Today's topic, again, this is a group exercise. What is it that we would like to talk about? Get people to volunteer topics and get somebody to volunteer to speak. And I'm now going to run through a few examples of what today's topic could be. I would personally always start with the wellness, with the road map. So this is whether people want to lose weight or maintain weight. And I think if you look at a wellness club, think about it in 12-week modules. It takes 12 weeks to start to form a good habit, and 12 weeks is also the length of a typical start of a subscription. Buy 3 and get the 4th for free. So I think a great product is the wellness roadmap, and obviously this is a great opportunity also to give out the 12-week challenge personal organisers. We can talk about the product for the day, and obviously come catalogue 5 we have a significantly enlarged range of products. And again, you don't have to be the product expert. Put the product there. It would be great if this is also the product which you sample during the wellness break, and use the product guide to get further information. We can talk through a checklist. Are we getting people to follow their good daily habits? Are they looking after themselves, drinking the right amount of water, eating the appropriate amount of fruit and vegetables and things like that? Do we teach people how to feel full? And this to me was a very interesting slide. The 20-minute rule. Now, if you come from a big family or just a hungry family, everybody likes to shovel food in their face as fast as they can. And your brain takes 20 minutes to receive a message from your stomach to say, I'm now full. I've had enough to eat. We all know that blood sugar levels vary during the day, and they will vary depending on the food that you eat. But if you're eating food, eat smaller portions, eat what you believe to be a sensible, balanced amount of food, and then wait 20 minutes. If at the end of 20 minutes your body is saying, I'm still hungry, then by all means have a small second portion. But really heed the warning here. If you eat a sensible portion of food, particularly if you've had a wellness natural balance shake 30 minutes beforehand, the chances are you will feel full by giving yourself that 20-minute delay. And also have a grading system where 1 is you're just about to pass out, you're so hungry and your body is craving sugar, and number 6 you're about to explode like Mr. Creosote off the Monty Python sketch. And make sure at the end of a meal you're feeling satisfied. So you're at a 5 or you're probably at a 4 or a 5, so you need to feel full at the end of your meal. Sleeping. This is one of the most obvious things, but go to bed 8 or 9 hours before you need to get up. Start your bedtime regime, knowing what time you have to get up in the morning, and give yourself enough time to enjoy a good night's sleep. Certain things that keep us awake at night, usually one of the things that keeps us awake more than anything is we haven't finished today's business. We've still got thoughts going through our mind. So before you go to bed, it's a good idea just to sit down with a glass of water and write down the things that are likely to trouble you. What are the things you have to do tomorrow? What are the questions that you have unresolved at the end of the day? Just jot them down. It will help you sleep. Also, reading a book is an excellent thing to do before bedtime. So again, read a book. It's a good way of ensuring you will have a good night's sleep. Now, apparently, this is reminiscent of me, although I absolutely dispute it, because I drive a car with the steering wheel on the other side of the car rather than on the left-hand side. But apparently, lots of overweight people are very stressful, and they eat basically because their life is out of control, or they're bored, or they're tired. People will find lots of reasons why that they eat inappropriate food and eat too much and too frequently. So topic number 6 is an idea. Have somebody talk about how they've managed their emotional eating and their stress-based eating. Optimal fat burning. This is an interesting one. Morning walks before breakfast. The longer the walk, the better, but no less than 30 minutes. The optimal way of burning fat is to raise your heart rate by about 100%. So if your heart rate is 60, oh, I've got somebody else who's just turned on their microphone and I've got an echo. I'm sorry. So the best thing to do is walk for about 30 minutes or jog for about 30 minutes. But if your resting heart rate is about 60, try to pace yourself with a heart rate of about 120. So if it's too fast, you do not burn fat. You burn fat when your heart rate is raised and raised for a long time, but it should not be extreme. Pumping iron in a gym is not the way to burn fat. Long walks and jogs are far, far better for you than that. It's also much better for your heart and joints. Get your loved ones. What better message could we have on Valentine's Day about getting your loved ones involved? Make sure that they are alongside you and that they will support you on your journey. It's often a difficult place, and we all like to eat at inappropriate times, but get your partner, get your friends, get your family on board. And again, maybe it will be wonderful to have your partner come along and share the story about how you have each managed to help one another along the path to becoming fit and healthy. Exercise. Sweat 3 times a week. Now, at this point, it'd be very easy to go off with some very inappropriate ideas, but you get the basic idea. Try to do some low or high intensity aerobic exercise. Go swimming, long walks, bike riding, dancing. Sit on a static bike, go on a jogging machine. It really doesn't matter what you do, but do something that causes you to sweat. It's great. It makes you feel good. Go and have a shower. Everybody feels better once they've undertaken some good, healthy exercise. Have somebody come and talk about the benefits of understanding food, what the calorific content is, and how you burn calories. So here's, for instance, how many calories are in a jacket potato? If it's topped with butter, about 175. A pint of beer is 150. For the Irish members watching this webinar, Guinness is the lowest calorific value beer that you can drink, and it also contains the most vitamins and minerals. So if you're going to drink beer, I can strongly recommend Guinness and hopefully give the Irish economy a boost at the same time. An apple, 70 calories a day. Look at these horrible burgers at the bottom and bacon sandwiches, 500 and 600, and that's before you put the fizzy drink and the chips alongside it as well. So it's very helpful if you have a basic understanding of the calories which various food substances contain. And it would also be very useful to know how much exercise you have to do to burn certain calories. And one of my guilty habits always used to be eating a digestive biscuit, because I always thought a digestive biscuit was a relatively healthy snack. A digestive biscuit is 70 calories, 70. and I need to run 1 kilometer to burn 70 calories. That's something I just know. And here's an example of, again, it would be nice during your topic and during the wellness club, have somebody talk through what they do and how many calories they burn. But basically doing a workout in a gym or going jogging or going running will burn about 300 calories in half an hour. Going for a walk is about half of that, 170. Going on a bike ride, about 260. And going swimming, also about 260. And it's really, really helpful that you understand how many calories are coming in and how many calories you burn during your daily exercise routine. There are also things that we have here to help you. And again, during the last webinar, Sophia and I went through this wellness health test online. It's really simple. It doesn't take long to do. And believe it or not, 11,500 people have already tried this online test. So it's a great thing to do during a wellness club. It's also a great thing to do when you're recruiting customers and potential club members to allow them to do that in the comfort of their own home as well. It's really quick, it's really simple, and it gives you some good guidance at the end. So how often should you run a wellness club and how long should they last? You can run as many as you want, as often as you want. It's entirely up to you. However, think about when is the right time of day. Often we're going to try and bring young mums into our wellness clubs. So maybe it is useful to do two on the same day. Do one during the day, so either after the mums have dropped the kids at school, so after the school run, or even late afternoon before the school run. But make it the same time every week. And if you're hiring a meeting room, why not see if you can do a deal with the hotel or the village hall where perhaps you can do a mum's club during the day between the school runs and then have one also in the evening, maybe after the school run at 6 o'clock. So you have two on the same day. Have as many as you want, as often as you want. But again, I would say an hour and a half to 2 hours is about right, with a wellness break and some exercise in the middle. We've given you lots of advice regarding Oriflame opportunity meetings about holding them at the same time and the same place every single week so people get in the habit of doing that. And our advice is exactly the same running your wellness club. Set them up, publish them, and get people in the habit of coming and attending. Make sure that people are encouraged to come along. We all have difficulties along the way, and if you have a difficult time or you've gained half a kilo or you've kind of lost your motivation, encourage people to come along and find reasons to praise them. People like to hear the words, well done, and all too often we don't hear those words sufficiently frequently. Find something good and find something that you can say well done, and give out rewards, whatever it may happen to be. Give out a wellness bar, give out something to say we recognize for what you've done, and make sure everybody in the room has the chance to be involved in your group. People will stay in the group if they feel part of the group. And finally, what's the objective of this? The objective is, and again, my advice would be, look at the life of your seed club, the one that you start with, being about a 12-week program from start to finish. At the end of that, what I hope you will see with a business hat on is it's a great way of bringing people in, encouraging them to live a healthier lifestyle, and also a way of encouraging them to buy and recruit more people into this wonderful business of ours. So the objective should be, during this 12-week period, you will find some people who want to exploit the opportunity, who are enthused and excited by the product and by the wellness clubs. So look to find the next people who will break out and start their own wellness clubs. So that is the sign of a great successful club, that one or two or many more people indeed wish to go off and emulate you and copy what you have just done. So that's it from me. I will now hand over to Sophia. So from me, this is the last word from me. Please enjoy a lovely Valentine's evening, and I look forward to seeing you or speaking to you next at the Catalog End webinar in 2 weeks' time. But I now hand back to Sophia Radomska.
Thank you, Eric. That was a fantastic short introduction into how the Wellness Club Day or the agenda can look like. So now we have heard the theory on how to run the Wellness Club, but it would be interesting to hear someone who is doing that in practice. Who can tell us a little bit more about what to focus on, what are the fun parts, what are the objectives, and so on. So what we have invited a very special international guest who is the top leader in Estonia and who is super successful with wellness. Her name is Katrin Lokotar, who runs a business together with her sister Helena. I will shortly tell you their story. Esther Lokotar, who is their mother, she started in Oriflame in 1997. Same year, she reached the title of director. In Estonia, they have a little bit different success plan than us in UK, and the director title is approximately the same as the district manager would be. So Esther Lokotar got the title the same year she started. 2007, her daughter Helena joined, and they together reached executive director title, one of the top titles. Helena Eha and Katrin Lokotar, two sisters, they joined together in 2012 when their mother retired. Today, they have opened the Sapphire Executive Director title and they plan to close it already in Catalog 5. And their biggest plan now for the future is to become presidents, to reach the highest title in the success plan of Oriflame in 2015. And let's see, I'm sure it's possible. So Katrin, welcome to our webinar. Would you please tell us a little bit more about how you became successful with wellness and what we need to focus when running the wellness clubs? Welcome.
Thank you very much. I'm very glad that you have asked us to share our experience. And to all of you who are listening, happy Valentine's. That's my kind of, can you all hear me? Just I'm checking.
Yes, Katrin, we can hear you very well.
Very good, very good. You heard my story that we have been in Oriflame business for quite a while, but my dream from a childhood actually was not to become a consultant in Oriflame or president, but to become a criminal lawyer. And that I became, and I did my studies in England, but I feel that in Oriflame business, we can really help even more people and looking and feeling great. But how can you be successful with wellness? We feel that, first of all, everything starts from yourself. You have to keep yourself fit. You have to find something, some physical activity that is kind of interesting to you or that you can do, because not everyone can run a marathon. It's not that easy, but to do yoga or stretching, power walking, a little bit jogging, it's all possible. And selling wellness, you need to actually also to the people will trust you. And the best thing is consume yourself all wellness products, as we ourselves are doing with my sister and our families, even our small boys who are now not so small anymore, 10 years old, their favorite shake is vanilla shake with apple juice. So everything starts again from yourself. But as I told that selling wellness is not easy, so you need to create trust that people will come to your activities, to your wellness clubs. So what we have done, that's we have done all different kind of activities, like wellness barbecues, that we barbecued everything else except meat, Shindo foot massage or yoga classes, and there we advertise that how good, great is to use wellness products and look and feel great. Wellness clubs, well, basically what our idea is mainly to have lifestyle clubs rather than weight loss clubs, because in Estonia we do not have that many overweight people. We have anyway 1.3 million is the population only, so we cannot only concentrate on weight loss, but rather just that people will feel good. We have wellness clubs every month we have one bigger wellness club, because in our network we have 8,000 people all over Estonia. So we have our bigger wellness clubs, that's 100 or 200 people are participating. And there we have basically three steps. First, we have obviously that's like a lecture type, that we choose a topic. Then we have exercises all the time, and always tasting. And we choose for tasting really one product that's their event. And it really, people love that a lot. Well, in Estonia, we also have a little bit summer, 3 months or so, the same as you have in UK and Ireland. So wellness clubs can be run also outside. And what is the Nordic walking or power walking or whatever you want to call it, this is also very, very good because everyone can do that. So the same is, first we have like a lecture and then together we teach how to do Nordic walking or power walk, and then we walk together. And as you all know, we also, Oriflame was the great supporter in women tennis. So we had also tennis clubs, and again, not only playing tennis, but talking about wellness. And we have mostly, most of the year in Estonia is cold, so all the activities must be done indoor. So spas or like clubs are is excellent, excellent place. And in Estonia, like water aerobics, again, everyone can do that. Everyone can do exercises in water. It's fun and it's also very healthy, and your joints will feel good. And the thing is, what we have done now lately, during the last year, is organizing Wellness Sundays. We choose an area in a town where we post to the letterboxes invites, and we ask people to walk together. And there we also, again, give shakes and wellness bars. And people who actually finish, they get a product, a wellness product. And well, everywhere we have, put the slide back, please, that we have health-related events, marathons or women's days. So it's a very good idea to be present in there and to share your experiences, to give, to taste wellness products. And the next, please. And the most important, well, you cannot do everything yourself. As we have, you have to train the trainers. Those, the more people are doing the same thing as you are doing, the more successful you will be. As we are running only one like huge wellness club per month, but every day our leaders whom we have trained are doing and running wellness clubs every day. So it's very important. Wellness catering. This what we have realized that is actually quite good idea. We have offered to companies who are having like seminars that to have wellness break, that they do not have to order in, but we are doing shakes, soups, and now infusions are available. So we have wide range of healthy food and very easy to prepare. You do not need a kitchen. As you can see from the picture, you can do it in the park. Next. And the very latest thing, or maybe to say that what we have kind of the good idea that our Indonesian partners are doing, that wellness clubs on Facebook. It's easier because people usually, you know, they if they already go home, they do not want to leave their houses, or they live very far apart. So it's very good to share your experiences and to have wellness clubs on Facebook, that you have your own group, that you create wellness group, and you share daily or weekly, how you want, that all your best practices, recipes, what to do, you do weightening, everything through internet, Facebook, as we are doing today. I'm in Tallinn and you are who knows where. Next, please. And the really, with wellness, you can be healthy and you can be wealthy, because wellness products give a lot of BPs and BPs give you money. So this is my very kind of short overview, what we do with wellness clubs, and I really wish you all the best, but the thing is to get started, because if you will not start tomorrow or next week, then you will never start with your wellness clubs. This is what we have experienced, so we always start now. Thank you.
Thank you, Kadrin, for this very inspiring story. Wow, this gives us so many ideas on how to succeed with the wellness club, and as you said, let's get started immediately. And it has been a great pleasure to listen to you, and I'm so inspired now that I just want to run out there and do my own club. Thanks again for sharing your time on this St. Valentine's Day, and on behalf of Oriflame UK and Ireland, we all wish you all the best with Oriflame and wellness, and good luck on your way to reach the president title.
Thank you.
Thank you. So today we covered the third step of the Wellness Academy. And this means that for those of you who have attended all three webinars, you will receive the Wellness Academy certificate. It will be sent to you by post. There will be another run of the Wellness Academy webinars start in catalog 5, which will give you a chance for those of you who missed one of our three webinars to attend and get a diploma. So in catalog 5, we will start another run of the webinars. We will also have a special wellness catalog launch webinar introducing all new products in connection with the catalog 5 business webinar, which is on March 21st. So join us on March 21st and hear more about new upcoming products. As of today, we are selling wellness catalogs, and they can be purchased in three different ways. You can buy them as single units, and you can see the code on the screen. Please pay attention, there are different codes if you want to buy in packs of 5. And they are also available as a pack together with the ordinary, with the normal catalog. So you can buy them as single, as packs of 5, or as a pack together with a normal cosmetic catalog 5. So again, today we covered the third and the last step of the Wellness Academy. I hope you got inspired. And as you all are now certified wellness ambassadors, we hope that you will go out and spread the Feel Great movement. Spread the movement and motivate, inspire, change people's lives, open wellness clubs. And as Kadrin said, do it immediately, get started now, because maybe tomorrow they will be already too late. Do it today. Wellness clubs, they will bring you health and business benefits, not only to yourself, but also to your family, friends, to your whole community, so invite everyone. And remember the success formula when you start to sell wellness. Use the products daily, share your or others' success stories, ask for the order, and follow up. And remember that Wellness by Oriflame is not a diet, it's a lifestyle, which consists of the wellness products, food tips, exercise, and support. But you know all this now, so you can go out and recommend all this through your wellness clubs. So be successful, look and feel great with Wellness by Oriflame, and see you all on the next webinar, and have a fantastic Valentine's Day. Thank you.
Thanks, everybody. Thank you, Kadrin. Thank you, Sophia. Have a wonderful Valentine's Day, and...
I knew that I wouldn't. So good, so good. I got you here. Oh, I feel nice. The sugar runs by. I feel nice. sugar is pop. Tonight, tonight, I got you. When I hold you in my arms, I know that I can't do no wrong. And when I hold you in my arms, my love won't do you no harm. And I feel nice, I feel the response. I feel nice, I feel the response. So nice, so nice, I got you here. I feel nice, that sugar and spice.